We've already talked about the basic idea of limits. We've looked at using graphs and reading those graphs to answer different questions about limits. Now what we want to move on to is the idea of evaluating limits. So using an algebraic method, so some method besides looking at the graph of a function, to answer those same types of questions. One of the first questions that can arise there is, why do we need this other approach? Why can't we always just rely on graphs? That seems to give us all of the information that we need. So the problem is that when we use a graphical approach, to answer limit questions, that method or that approach can sometimes fail. So taking a look at this function we've got below, this looks like a relatively simple function, curving down. A few things that we could pick up on is, for instance, we could infer that this graph is just going to keep going down, plummeting to negative infinity. There don't seem to be any holes or breaks in it. But in reality, this is the graph of f of x equals x minus 5 over x minus 5 times x minus 12. Depending on what you do or don't remember from classifying vertical asymptotes, other things like that, there are a couple pieces of information that we can pick up on from this function. One is that because we have this x minus 5 in the denominator, and x minus 12 in the denominator, there are going to be two different values for x where this function is undefined. So for instance, at x equals 5, our function will be undefined, so technically we should have an open circle at x equals 5 to indicate that. So when we start talking about what's happening around some of these different x values, well, at x equals 5, what we actually see is that that value f of 5 is undefined. Which means it should be represented by this open circle on the graph. But characteristics of a graph like that are typically hidden by technology. So whatever tool we use to graph this function, usually this hole in the graph won't be indicated. So we don't see that in this graph, even though technically it should be represented there. The other issue with this graph is that if we extended it to x equals 12, we would actually have a vertical asymptote occurring. So as we approach that asymptote from the left, this function is going to continue dipping down to negative infinity. But then on the other side of that asymptote, we would have a curve that looks more or less like that. So in this case, f of 12 is also undefined. In this case, because we would have a vertical asymptote for the graph. And our problem here was that our viewing window was misleading. Or the original domain that we were given for this graph didn't show us the complete picture. There was this very kind of important part of the graph that was missing, that asymptote and that change in behavior of the function. So graphs can mislead us because we might not see these open circles or undefined points. Or if our window is incorrect or our domain for the graph is incorrect, we may not see important characteristics. So to avoid being misled, by reading limits from graphs, what we want to do in this section is establish methods for evaluating limits algebraically. So some techniques to ensure that we're finding the correct answers to these types of questions, and then again, not looking at a graph that's throwing us off or leading us in the wrong direction. So briefly here, we'll reestablish our definitions for limits. So the limit of some function f of x as x approaches c is going to be equal to L if our function value f of x is approaching some value L as x approaches that value c. And then we have this theorem that relates our one-sided limits with our limit expression. So we can say that the limit of our function exists and is equal to this value f if and only if the limit as we approach from the right-hand side equals the limit as we approach c from the left-hand side are both equal to the same value l. So we'll make use of the idea of this definition, we'll make use of these one-sided limits, but what we're going to be doing now is establishing a new approach where instead of looking at graphs, we use some algebraic methods to evaluate limits and come up with these different answers.